Assalamu alaikum again. My dear beloved brother and sister, I am so honored. When you are on the air, you can't say what you want to say. You know what I mean. You can't take your time like you want to do it. It takes more than one time. It's a long history that you have made here in America. I heard Master Farad Muhammad, just like you sitting there, I sit there, and the messenger and him was on the rostrum. He said to us, he said, you are making history.
Yes, sir.
At that time, he told us that. He would say it often, and he would come to the temple, because he would come plenty of times after a man named Abdul Muhammad, after he had pulled away from Master Farad, wanting to become the great I Am himself. And Master Farad Muhammad named him. But he wanted to say that Master Farad Muhammad was a devil. I want to say this to you, many of you that have seen the picture of Master Farad Muhammad. His eyes looks as though he's got them closed, right? His eyes was as black as yours. And he told us one day at the meeting that he had to come like that in order to get to you on both sides. Because our people here don't mind a white man coming in their house. And telling them something, they say, yeah, Mr. So-and-so said that was right. So he had to come in that manner. That's the body that in the Bible says, prepare me a body and I will go down on man's mom. That is the body that was made so that he could come to us and he could go in to the white people and bring back to you what they are doing. And he did so. Of course, he didn't have to go there to tell them what he's doing. Let me show you something. Here in Chicago, in 1933, Master Farad Muhammad and the teachers, messenger, and officials was here. Number two was not fit up at that time. We were just only getting around to different people trying to get enough together. So he taken me to, as we was in a flower house here, you might know where it is, I couldn't go back to it now. He taken me up to this devil. He said of me after we got away from the rest of them, he says, come on, Muhammad. My name was Muhammad Sharif at that time. I had two names, Muhammad Sharif. Then he gave me John Muhammad. And he said, come on, Muhammad. He didn't never use the name Muhammad like we use it. He says, Muhammad, which is written. And he says, see that devil over there? I said, yes, sir. He says, we want to go to someplace. I don't remember. But anyway, he says, we want to go there. He says, I'm going to show you that I know more about the city than he do. Now, he's going to tell us to go all out of the way when we don't have far to go. I thought in myself, well, what the hell are you going over there to ask him for then? And you already know. But you know, he was teaching me that he understood and know. So we get to the devil. He asked him, he says, Me and my brother, this man here, we wants to go to such and such a place. He looked at him. He says, oh, yeah. Just like he had told me. Some street he called and go left, turn right and whatnot, and then you'd be there. So he says to him, he says, thank you. And he walks back. He goes back to the rest of the people, our people. He says, I told you, John, Mahmoud, he says, I told you that I know the city better than he do. He told us wrong. He says, now we're going to go there. And we went right to the place where he wanted to go, didn't ask anyone else, but he showed to me how the devil will misguide and mislead a people when you're depending on them. That's what he was teaching me in that little space of time. Do not put your trust and hope into this Caucasian white devil, because he's going to lead you wrong.
Right.
So, there's many things happen during time that I was around him and the messenger. And one day, as I was going to say, we was having teachers' meeting on 8 Mile Road in Ferndale, Michigan. We was out there that day, it was on a holiday. And he said to all of the officials, while the other part of the fruit was plain bald, he said to them, he says, will you take my credit and give it to another? We all say, no, we would not do that. We would not take your credit and give it to somebody else. And that's the fact. But what we did, I say we because so many of them at that time, taking the teachings that he had given to us and went and give it to another, give them the credit for what he had taught us. And that he knew and was teaching us, don't you do it. And now here comes up my nephew, W.D., and takes the credit away from both men, Master Farad and Messenger Elijah Muhammad, for himself. And look at the fall that came upon them. After doing so, you just can't take God's word and his work and play with it. He taught us time after time, if you don't want Islam, brothers and sisters, don't take it. Leave it alone. Because it is the fire. It will burn you. And that's true. You may not think it's burning you, but the other person sees and knows exactly that you have a flame of fire following you. They can see it, but you don't see it. That is living. So I say to you, my dear one, at this time, there is much I could say to you concerning what has happened in the 3 years that I was present among the followers and among the officials of Islam during the time of Master Farad Muhammad and the messenger at his right. He is all. He is the oldest one that will come to you, as I was saying here. I couldn't break it down, but at the time, to break it down over the air, because it takes too long to tell these things, because it is a history of you.
Yes, sir.
If you don't believe it's a history, go and try and find the Muslims
in America, the history of what they did, you will find different letters, as I have tried to find them back in 35, 36. I went to the library and I found just a written type. It was not booked yet. And now they want to allow anyone to see it. I have been back to try to find it. And the name was initial, like M-S and B-O and whatnot. The initials. And was telling what those people did. If I could find just that again, I would know who the people is, even if I had forgotten their name, by the work that they was doing in the temple at that time. But I can't get it. They won't let you have it. Now, when I seen that, I couldn't bring it out. I would have copied the whole thing. But I couldn't bring it out. I had to sit right before this devil woman and read it. She's sitting in front of me, and a little table about as wide as this here, and I had to read it that way. And she's making me forget what I'm reading by looking in her blue eyes. So, I say to you, this is the honest way, is to follow the teachings of Messenger Elijah Muhammad.
Yes.
Minister Farrakhan is doing the best work that I have seen a man do. Sit to the departure of Messenger Elijah Muhammad in the Nation of Islam. Stick with him. Stick with him. Bring more to him. Bring more. Allah will bless you. You will never regret the day that you have came to become a follower under the new Islam taught by Messenger Elijah Muhammad. It is a new Islam. He mentioned it himself. And when he mentioned it, saying in that day, they will call it the new Islam. He said, all right, now before he wrote it, it was saying it will be the new Islam among the people. And however, he states that this new Islam had to go into other countries. Now, further concerning it, Master Farad Muhammad taught us that we have to take this same Islam that he brought to you and I and go back to the east and clean up the city that you say is the holy city of Mecca. Master Farad Muhammad said, you got to clean it up.
Yes, yeah. Right. Oh, yeah.
Yes, sir.
Now, where is your holy city? I'm from here. But you got to clean it up.
Yes.
Detroit is the Mecca that is referred to as the Mecca in the East.
Yes, sir.
But you got to clean it up. There is one city that I saw a portion of the picture of it, but it wasn't on long enough for me to distinguish, was this the place that Master Farad Muhammad was talking about? Because the children, when this devil said children is there, that wear necklace around their neck that worth more than J.P. Morgan, Henry Ford, and Rockefeller put together. The stones in it is worth more than them three men put together. And when he went to say, this is the real, off it goes. I said, I couldn't get it. If you tell it, I'll know what Master Farad said, and I'll know if this is the place. No more. Plenty of people have not heard it. Plenty of them have not seen it. But you got to feel your... Don't pay that any attention. That ain't nothing. You don't look at me and think that I'm
said, now I'll tell you what Master Farhan Muhammad said about that.
Right.
He said, that is nothing but the cold and the heat meeting together. And the devil, he writes it too. That's all it is. He gave us a fact about it. Lightning cannot be heard over 15 miles. Lightning and thunder is the same thing. And if you're in the way of it, why, just forget about it. Excuse me, brother. Let us out. I get to talking on that. I'll be here all night. On the things and the facts that Master Farhan give us, and the knowledge that he taught us all night long, and the messenger taught us all night, I have sit all night long with the most. All night. I mean all night. I have sit all night with the messenger in my home. From the going down of the sun to the rising of it, I did the same thing on Woodlawn here in Detroit. I mean Chicago. Time after time. I'm not bragging about myself. Remember now. I'm not trying to put a rose on myself. I'm only telling you what I was lucky enough to be in and hear it. And if they didn't mean for me to tell you, they shouldn't have never allowed me in their midst. Because I got a big mouth. I say it to you, to the lost found brother and sister that is present, I say to you, as the messenger has said, join on to your own time. Get into your own nation of people. Now you, it was broken down. We use the word join. But you cannot join. We was taught that the only thing you can do is to reclaim what belongs to you. And when you do that, then you come back into the fold of this line, into your own nation of peace. And you will find out that you are the greatest people ever lived or died. There is so much in Islam to learn, so much to be taught. That's why Master Farhan I'm just like the messenger was, I don't talk over 6 hours. And I love to talk here. I used to go to the temple and see Master Farhan teaching. I used to say, I wish I could tell that like he's telling it. One thing that hooked me, and he said, all white people is the devil. I was glad to hear it. Because as a little boy, I found it out. And just like you, if you had came from Georgia like I did, and seen how white people in my time and some of your time, it's all right. I'll go with you. And you would. Like a lot of people say to us, we all is from one blood. White, black, red, yellow, and green, all from one blood. Tell them, yeah, that's right. We all from one blood.
Yes, sir.
They are from us. as the messenger used to tell me, he says, brother, we made him. That's
right.
Yeah, Mama. But the thing that made it so different today, his blood is no more the same. After the grafting was over with, it's made him to come through 12 processes of grafting since the years made a change. And when it did, that throws off all of the original blood. Now, at the end of his 600 years of death, for him to be made in these 12 processes, he's no more the same.
Yes, sir.
He don't look like you. Yes. He don't act like you. He don't talk like you. He is not you.
Yes,
because you have pulled out from your original brother by using the unwanted, if you wanted to say so, using the brown jury. The brown jury represents an unwanted something, so we let Columbus discover the full part of the earth, right? We let him do it. So we let Yaku make a devil from the pole part of the original man. You get me now? So in making him from the original man, that causes him to grow weak. Bones is weak. His eyes become weak. He has boils and everything on his skin.
Right.
I was looking at one this morning on TV. All over his face, nothing but little old ugly moles and things. I looked at him. I said, "Well, Yaku sure made you." So a lot of that is knowledge for you to know. Nobody tried to condemn Messenger Elijah Muhammad, but the little poor black fools.
That's right.
When they went in Detroit to tell the white people about Muhammad teaching Islam and teaching that they were devils, the devil told them, go away from them, or you're going on back and don't pay him any attention. Say, that man don't know what he's talking about. He is crazy. And that's what they say. They tell you that. They say, go away today and tell what I'm saying. He said, oh, that guy's crazy.
Right.
No. Brother and sister, be of good comfort. Be of good cheer. At this juncture, may I ask you, if you're here for your first time, or if you're here for your third or fourth time, and you have not reclaimed your own title, which is Islam, so that you may be sit right along beside it,
yes,
by reclaiming it, will you do so today? Will you reclaim your own title, which is Islam, the nation of Islam? The Lions don't call themselves a nation. They does not call themselves the original man. Other people honors black more than they do Belalian. Listen over your radio and see how many white people call you Belalian. They don't have nothing to do with Belalian. They say, the blacks. That's what I hear. I say to you, you might say, why you talk about that? Because I don't want to see you go wrong. Well, they have Juma prayer, and they pray five times a day. But you used to pray five times a day, and you don't move.
All right. Explain.
But you used to pray for something, and it's being taken away from you all the while. I say to you, no, I love prayer better, I believe, than any other man.
Yes.
Because Allah answers my prayer.
Yes.
Just like he answers you. We pray that you might accept your all tithes. Now who will come up and accept your tithes? I don't say it's just for you to come to God. Master Farad Muhammad said, it is immaterial to me. Listen to what I'm saying. He said, it is immaterial to me whether you accept it or don't accept it.
That's right.
You will be fine. Just the same. I'm not trying to scare you. But I was saying, where else are you going to get the draw and the real teaching of Islam other than in the temple of Messenger Elijah Muhammad? I thank you, brothers and sisters. If you didn't understand, don't want to come back and be in the meeting. Come back and be in the meeting. I thank you. I hope to come back to you again. May Allah bless you and grant to you your desire. As-salamu alaykum.
Wa alaykum as-salam.
Muhammad Sharif at that time. I had two names, Muhammad Sharif. Then he gave me John Muhammad. And he said, come on. Now, he didn't never use the name Muhammad like we use it. He says Muhammad, which is written. And he says, see that devil over there? I said, yes, sir. He says, we want to go to someplace. I don't remember. But anyway, he says, we want to go there. He says, I'm going to show you that I know more about the city than he do. Now, he's going to tell us to go all out of the way when we don't have far to go. I thought in myself, well, what the hell are you going over there to ask him for then? And you already know. But, you know, he was teaching me that he understood and know. So we get to the devil. He asked him, he says, me and my brother, this man here, we wants to go to such and such a place. He looked at him. He says, oh, yeah, yeah. Just like he had told me, some speedy called and go left, turn right, and whatnot, and then you'd be there. So he says to him, he says, thank you. And he walks back. He goes back to the rest of the people, our people. He says, I told you, John, Muhammad. He says, I told you that I know the city better than he do. He told us wrong. He says, now we're going to go there. And we went right to the place where he wanted to go. Didn't ask anyone else. But he showed to me how the devil
will misguide and mislead a people when you're depending on them. That's what he was teaching me in that little space of time. Do not put your trust and hope into this Caucasian white devil, because he's going to lead you wrong.
Right.
So, well, there's many things happen during the time that I was around him and the messenger. Indeed, one day, as I was going to say, we was having teachers' meeting out on 8 Mile Road in Ferndale, Michigan. We was out there that day, it was on a holiday. Break it down, one at a time, to break it down over the air, because it takes too long to tell these things, because it is a history of you.
Yes, sir.
If you don't believe it's a history, go and try and find the Muslims in America, their history of what they did. You will find different letters, as I have tried to find back in 35, 36. I went to the library and I found just a written type. It was not booked yet. And now they won't allow anyone to see it. I have been back to try to find it, and the names was initials, like M-S and B-O and whatnot. They initials, and was telling what those people did. If I could find just that again, I would know who the people is, even if I had forgotten their name, by the work that they was doing in the temple at that time. But I can't get it. They won't let you have it. Now, when I seen that, I couldn't bring it out. I would have copied the whole thing, but I couldn't bring it out. I had to sit right before this devil woman and read it. She's sitting in front of me, and a little table about as wide as this here, and I had to read it that way. And she's making me forget what I'm reading by looking in her blue eyes. So, I say to you, this is the honest way, is to follow the teachings of Messenger Elijah Muhammad.
Yes.
Minister Farrakhan is doing the best work that I have seen a man do. Sit to the departure of Messenger Elijah Muhammad in the Nation of Islam. Stick with him. Stick with him. Bring more to him. Bring more. Allah will bless you. You will never regret the day that you have came to become a follower under the new Islam taught by Messenger Elijah Muhammad. It is a new Islam. He mentioned it himself. And when he mentioned it, saying, in that day, they will call it the new Islam. He said, all right, now before he wrote it, it was saying, it will be the new Islam among the people. And thank you. And he walks back. He goes back to the rest of the people, our people. He says, I told you, John, Muhammad, he says, I told you that I know the city better than he do. He told us wrong. He says, now we're going to go there. And we went right to the place where he wanted to go. Didn't ask anyone else. But he showed to me how the devil will misguide and mislead a people when you're depending on them. That's what he was teaching me in that little space of time. Do not put your trust and hope into this Caucasian white devil, because he's going to lead you wrong.
Right.
So, there's many things happen during the time that I was around him and the messenger. Indeed, one day, as I was going to say, we was having teachers' meeting
out in 8 Mile Road in Ferndale, Michigan. He was out there that day. He was on a holiday. And he said to all of the officials, while the other part of the fruit was plain bald, he said to them, he says, will you take my credit and give it to another? We all say, no, we would not do that. We would not take your credit and give it to somebody else. And that's the fact. But what we did, I say we because so many of them at that time, taking the teachings that he had given to us and went and give it to another, give them the credit for what he had taught us. And that he knew and was teaching us, don't you do it. And now here comes up my nephew, W.D., and takes the credit away from both men, Master Farad and Messenger Elijah Muhammad, for himself. And look at the fall that came upon them. After doing so, you just can't take God's word. And we are from one of them. They are from us. As the messenger used to tell me, he says, brother, we made him. And that's right. They are from our blood. But the thing that made it so different today, his blood is no more the same. After the grafting was over with, it's made him to come through 12 processes of grafting since the years made a change. And when it did, that throws off all of the original blood. Now, at the end of his 600 years of death, for him to be made in these 12 processes, he's no more the same.
Yes, sir.
He don't look like you. Yes. He don't act like you. He don't talk like you. He is not you.
Yes, sir.
Because you have pulled out from your original brother by using the unwanted, if you wanted to say so. Using the brown jury. The brown jury represents an unwanted something, so we let Columbus discover the full part of the earth, right? We let him do it. So we let Yaku make a devil from the full part of the original man. You get me now? So in making him from the original man, that causes him to grow weak. Bones is weak. His eyes become weak. He has boils and everything on his skin.
But
I was looking at one this morning on TV. All over his face. Nothing but little old ugly moles and things. I looked at him. I said, well, Yaku sure made you. So a lot of that is knowledge for you to know. Nobody tried to condemn Messenger Elijah Muhammad, but the little poor black fools.
That's right.
When they went in Detroit to tell the white people about Muhammad teaching Islam and teaching that they were devils. The devil told them, go away from them, or either go. It takes more than one time. It's a long history that you have made here in America. I heard Master Farad Muhammad. Just like you sitting there, I sit there, and the messenger and him was on the rostrum. He said to us, he said, you are making history.
Yes, sir.
At that time, he told us that. He would say it often, and he would come to the temple, because he would come plenty of times after a man named Abdul Muhammad, after he had pulled away from Master Farad, wanting to become the great I Am himself. And Master Farad Muhammad named him. But he wanted to say that Master Farad Muhammad was a devil. I want to say this to you, many of you that have seen the picture of Master Farad Muhammad. His eyes looks as though he's got them closed, right? His eyes was as black as yours. And he told us one day at the meeting that he had to come like that in order to get to you on both sides. Because our people here don't mind a white man coming in their house. And telling them something, they say, yeah, Mr. So-and-so said that was right. So he had to come in that manner. That's the body that in the Bible says, prepare me a body and I will go down on man's mom. That is the body that was made so that he could come to us and he could go in to the white people and bring back to you what they are doing. And he did so. Of course, he didn't have to go there to tell them what he was doing. Let me show you something. Here in Chicago, in 1933, Master Farad Muhammad and the teachers, messenger, and officials was here. Number two was not fit up at that time. We were just only getting around to different people trying to get enough together. So I did the same thing on Woodlawn here in Chicago. Time after time. I'm not bragging about myself. Remember now. I'm not trying to put a rose on myself. I'm only telling you what I was lucky enough to be in and hear it. And if they didn't mean for me to tell you, they shouldn't have never allowed me in their midst. Because I got a big mouth. I say to you, to the lost found brother and sister that is present, I say to you, as the messenger has said, join on to your own time. Get into your own nation of people. Now you, it was broken down. We use the word join. But you cannot join. We was taught that the only thing you can do is to reclaim what belongs to you. And when you do that, then you come back into the fold of this line, into your own nation of peace. And you will find out that you are the greatest people ever lived or died. There is so much in Islam to learn, so much to be taught. That's why Master Farad I'm just like the messenger was, I don't talk for over 6 hours. And I love to talk here. I used to go to the temple and see Master Farad teaching. I used to say, I wish I could tell that like he's telling it. One thing that hooked me, and he said, all white people is the devil. I was glad to hear it. Because as a little boy, I found it out. And just like you, if you had came from Georgia like I did, and seen there is so much in Islam to learn, so much to be taught. That's why Master Farad I'm just like the messenger was. I don't talk for over 6 hours. And I love to talk here. I used to go to the temple and see Master Farad teaching. I used to say, I wish I could tell that like he's telling it. One thing that hooked me, and he said, all white people is the devil. I was glad to hear it. Because as a little boy, I found it out. And just like you, if you had came from Georgia like I did, and seen how white people in my time and some of your time, it's all right. I'll go with you. And you would. Like a lot of people say to us, we all is from one blood. White, black, red, yellow, and green, all from one blood. Tell them, yeah, that's we all from one blood. They are from huh? As the messenger used to tell me, he says, brother, we made him. And that's right. They are from our blood. But the thing that made it so different today, his blood is no more the same. After the grafting was over, it's made him to come through 12 processes of grafting, shift to yield, made the change. And when it did, that throws off all of the original blood. Now, at the end of his 600 years of grafting, for him to be made in these 12